This is the tool that actually cuts this line, the MCQ. All you have to do is just turn it, spin it, and it will cut it. An inch from where you will mark it, because this thickness of this tool is 1 inch, so you need to have 1 inch of extra. This is where you're going to start this end, so you will have 4 inches on the other end.
Then we decide to go over.
To this point, up to the line, get a pair of channel locks. You do not squeeze this very hard, you will crimp it, and then you ruin the whole cable. So what you do is make sure it's not on this side, it's on this side of the channel locks, and you go right up against it. And with that, what this does is stops from winding up, and it will cut it straight at the end. This is what you should have. And this is a perfect straight cut all the way around. Sandpaper. You got strips on it, and you gotta clean this piece up to here. This is time consuming, so whoever's doing this, take your time, do it right. Set of hands, but if you don't, you use your knee to support it. What I found out is a piece of roll of tape, you shove it on there, and you work good. Thank you. sometimes it doesn't work. They want you to clean this really well so you can have a good contact when you do the crimping on it. Especially in this part. This part, you clean it so you can fit the ferrules over it and it will slide up and down. You will see down on it.
And then for 5 days, it went viral. You can accept the schematic and you can take it over by the
way. We'll get back to this. We'll walk sand. The next step is the kit to give you all these. I will explain to you every one. That's one. Instructions. Make sure you read this booklet. This booklet is the key to understanding why are you doing all this. They give you two putties. You cannot touch these with your hands, gloves, or anything. They specify that you can't touch these. They give you the tapes and the sleeve that goes over the crimp right down here. That's all at here. This is a label that you put up on top of the cable stating the installation. There's the emery tool. This you don't need for now. Put it on the side. This is the one that you need. You unscrew it. And you take this piece and this piece. This you put on the side. Now this piece here, if you can see, the sleeve goes over this. When you're all done with this piece, this is the piece that threads on to the outside of this sleeve. That's why it's important to clean this. This piece here is the ferrule that it locks on the outside of this sleeve. If you overtime this ferrule, you will crush the inside of this and it will touch, and this will have a dead short or it will fail the test. So you put the ferrule back in there, screw it on, slide this whole thing. This is the first thing that gotta go on. See, that's why you clean it, so you can slide this all the way up. I like to put a piece of tape, any kind of tape, just to keep that from sliding down. This is where your main concern is. This piece. To do this installation, you need to have this tool. This comes apart, these rods threaded, and I made a mistake. This has to get threaded here. They do not recommend you using channel locks. You're supposed to use crescent wrenches, but I just snug these. Now, once this is snug, in here is where this barrel sits, and you can't push it all the way in because this screw here will crush. As you can see, it's thin over here, thick over here. So you want to catch it on the thick part. Snug this down, don't go too crazy. Once you hear that, that's tight. So the reason why they want you to do this is they want you to screw this barrel in here straight. If you don't have this on here and this on, you'll never get it straight. It'll be all crooked. You'll never get this thing together ever. They do not say anything about oil. You shouldn't use oil. The reason why I'm using it, just a little bit of oil on the outside here, it cannot contact the inside of this. This ferrule is extremely hard to screw onto this piece because you have to pass this outside like 1/8 of an inch inside this barrel, and it's extremely hard because you start twisting the outside of it, and that's not good. So I found that a little bit of WD-40 only on the outside, just a little bit, makes it thread in very easily. You do not spray this off. That's it. So then you take this tool, you insert it. Sorry, this barrel gotta go up. You push and twist. Push and twist. And you grab with two hands. Inside that barrel is to have 1/8 of an inch of the outside sleeve passing through, which I have that, so this is done. So what you do is you take your John locks and you remove the back side. Now you pull this up. Inside here, as you can see, this piece now will slide right over. If you don't use this tool, it will never slide over. You will have such a hard time. So right now you don't need this over this, put it on top, put a piece of tape, let it stay there. Now this piece here, you have to insulated, because if you get moisture into this cable, it will fail the test. So that's why they give you those little green outside here. Four corners. This in case you have material, metal, metallic stuff on your hands or razors or anything like that, they don't want you to touch it. But since I have my gloves on, all I want to do is fold this and make it thicker. This is like putty. Then what you do, this sleeve here is hollow inside. They want you to fill this up with this. So you got, don't drop, fill it from one side till it comes out over to the other side. So grab it, pull up on it. As you can see, it's going in there. You want to pack this really, really good. The reason is, you don't want to have any pockets. Not there. At all. Extra after this, it's a little messy, but it's fine. Sorry about the background, they have a meeting. So basically this is what you're gonna have. This is extra. What I like to do is, the piece that I peeled off, the other piece, is you take it and you wipe it all down.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
This kit, you have to have, this is the tool. It's a very weird looking tool, but once you understand what it does, it's an amazing tool. It has a hole shape and a hole on the bottom. So what basically what you do with this is you slide it in, and this will go right above the ferrule, as you can see. And then this you tie it up. The important part about this, it has three diamond shaped wedges. This piece here has a little plastic bushing inside, and this is a Bakelite type of washer. What you need to do with this is put it all the way inside this barrel, and at the same time crimp the outside of this barrel to keep this inside. That stops from any moisture going into this cable. So the way you put this on is, I like to pull that plastic piece. This is the plastic piece, and it's combed, so it has to face the inside of the cable, and you put it all the way to the edge, just like that. Then what I do is put it in and work it, twist it, pull it, till you get it, and you will get some green paste out of as you're squeezing it. The more you squeeze it, the more it will come out. So you just wipe it down. As you can see now, this is not sitting all the way. So this is where this little beautiful tool comes in play. Make sure you center it on those three triangle pieces, and you tighten up the screws. Get a screwdriver and you start screwing it. As you drive the screws upwards, the Bakelite washer will set itself inside the barrel, pushing more of that paste out, but centering itself inside. This tool, as it's pushing the washer in, once it bottoms out to the bottom on the inside, it automatically crimps the outside of the barrel in three spots, which is amazing, this little tool. Whoever thought about it is a genius. Just inspect it to see if it's going straight. You tighten up these screws to the bottom out, you can't go no more. You have to do that in order to crimp completely that barrel and have the Bakelite washer inside. Seconds. The reason is it's still pushing out the paste, if you can see it. I don't know if you can see it, but the pressure inside is pushing everything out. So basically, that's about it. Now you unscrew it. Basically, you take it out the way you took it to put it in, pull it out, as you can see. That's the dum-dum that it comes out, the paste. It's a special paste. And that's it. Now, you clean this excess out. Basically, that's what you have. You can see it. I will put some light on it. See how the Bakelite is in there? And it has 1, 2, 3 crimps. So now, this piece is completely ready. Tape on. Slide this over. So basically, this is your protection in here when it gets all spliced. this is the other piece that they give you. This gets crimped over here together with the bottom of the cable that I have to set up. First you have to set this up. And then once everything is set up inside, you slide this all the way up. This actually has to go all the way up here. You do all your crimping down here with the tool, with the two cables, and then you slide this barrel over it. You attach it to the bottom one, which is this one, has to go on the bottom cable. So you screw this piece in, and then you slide this down to the ferrule. This goes right over it. You tighten this down. And once everything is tight and crimped, you lock this up. And once you lock this and this, this will not move up and down like this. So basically this is what it's gonna look like. This is the first thing that you have to put on. You don't put this on first, you're screwed. You cannot get this over this. So, this is the first thing that has to go on the cables. And this is a very, very tight space. You're supposed to have 4 feet from this cable straight, and another 4 feet straight to the other side of the cable. The reason is because this big, huge insulation, you have to slide it over so you can do all your terminations, and then lock, crimp everything, slide it over, put everything together, and silicone everything. So you don't have to worry about this anymore, getting moisture into this cable. The reason is this green paste here stops that. So this is completely done. We'll put it on the side for now and start. Actually, I need this for measurement. We need to get this cable out. Cut it. Cut the cable right here for now. Made this home paddle. It is one of the best things that I made to shape this wire. All you have to do is beat it. Possible. This is not metal. This is homemade. You cannot use metal or anything like that. You can get a rubber mallet, and that's how you shape this big wire in. Otherwise, you cannot shape it in. 6 inches in between. It's an extremely hard cable to work with. And the thicker they get, the harder they are. So basically, what you want to do is make this as short as possible. That insulation. First thing, put this on. You forget to put this on, forget it. This is another tool that you strain out the cable. Slide it over. And just watch it. But this doesn't work in tight spaces. To pause this.